communion, you are declaring, I have a fellowship with Christ. I have a relationship. We start with the relationship. I have a relationship with Jesus. I have a fellowship with Jesus. And I am in union with Jesus. So when you are taking the communion, it is not a religious rite. It is a declaration you are making. I have a relationship with Jesus by his death, his resurrection, by the work of the cross. It is the blood of Jesus that brought me again home. It is the blood of Jesus, that is what you are declaring, that made me now a son. I believed in him. I was washed by the blood. This is the blood that spoke for me. It spoke mercy when there was damnation and destruction declared over my life. This is the blood and the sacrifice that brought me back to God when I had run away from God from Adam. So at communion, you are declaring, I have a relationship with Jesus. I have a fellowship with Jesus. And I am in union with Jesus. That's powerful. You have become one with Christ. You have a relationship. You have become a son of God. You have a fellowship. He has become your friend. You are in union. You have become one with Christ. What a formidable force. What a formidable union. Whatever that is going to destroy people on the face of the earth, you have a relationship with God. You are not just having this, you are not only relating with him, creator, creation. You have become a son of God. You have become a son of God. If you are born again, you have become a son of God. And you declare that at the Holy Communion. When I lift the body and the blood of Jesus, I'm declaring, I have a relationship. I have a fellowship. I'm not only a son of God, I have a fellowship. And the fellowship is so close. He is not just a creator who is very far. He is a friend who sticks closer than my biological brother.